Hey, welcome back to another video. Today it's about this plugin, which is called Ozone Elements. And as you can see, it's available for free until October the 2nd. And I bought this plugin maybe a year ago, and I use it on every project on the mastering bus. And I only use the maximizer. You also get an imager and equalizer, which can be handy and you can use, of course. But in this video, I'm only using the maximizer and show you why I use it. So when we go down here to Bitwig Studio, I created a small project, which is completely Bitwig only. The only VST I used is the Ozone Elements plugin. And this plugin is on the mastering bus. And this is how the track sounds without the Ozone Elements plugin. So pretty dynamic, and of course we have to use a limiter on the master bus. And I'm using the Ozone here, and I disabled the equalizer and the imager, and I just leave the maximizer on. And normally, when you have a limiter, you take your threshold slider and go down until you are satisfied with the loudness level and the dynamic range. But in this case, you can set a specific loudness LUFS target level, which is here minus 40 LUFS. And maybe when you want a club track, so a bit louder, then you go to minus 10, and maybe you have drum bass, then you go for minus 6 or minus 4. But in our case here, we go for minus 14 LUFS. And you can set this output loudness there, and you just hit this learn threshold button. And then you play your track, and the threshold is then leveled until you hit this specific output loudness. So you can see the threshold is now leveled at a certain amount of dB here, which is minus 8.9. And when you see it, that's leveled at a certain amount of, to a certain amount, then you can stop the track and turn this learn threshold button off, because you can leave it on. And this is also a nice gimmick, because you can use it in a live situation where you want to have all the time a nice level of loudness. But in our case here, we just looped the loudest part in our track, which is probably this part here. And then we played it, measured the loudness, let the threshold settle to a certain amount, and then we turn off the learn threshold button, and then we can bounce down our track to audio. And we can be sure that the output level is exactly minus 40 LUFS, which is pretty great. And every time you change something in your track, the bass maybe, or your EQ something on the drums, your output loudness changes, right? Then you can go back here to the Ozone, just hit the learn threshold again, let the play run a certain amount of loops, and then turn it off, and then you have again your target loudness level, which is pretty great and no-brainer. And I use this plugin in this manner all the time. Also, when you let this track play here, can see the maximizer is working pretty hard here, and it's probably the kick drums. So this can also be a hint for you that maybe you have to fix something on your buses. And if we put the limiter here and use the limiter on the drums bus, we can remove the peaks there instead of the mastering bus. So now the mastering maximizer is not working so hard anymore. And maybe you say, well, what's the difference? Because in this case here, we have a pretty minimal track, so there's maybe no difference. But when you have a pretty heavy track with a lot of different tracks and pads and so on, of course, the mastering maximizer has also an influence on all the other tracks. And when you have a big kick drum coming through all the time and the maximizer is reducing the volume, then the pads are also influenced. Maybe you want this, maybe not. So in this case here, you can go to the drums bus and to remove the peaks there instead of removing the peaks in the mastering channel. So that's that. Also, you can change the character of your maximizer here. So you can move between the character of pretty upfront and more laid back when you have slower tracks or hip hop tracks or more vocals. Then you can slow down here the character. But in this case, it's a pretty percussion heavy song. The kick drum is pretty hard. Then we go for a fast character because we want all the transient in there. Also, you can use this transient emphasis method here on the right side, which makes sure that all your transient are not destroyed in the maximizing process. So when you have some precious transient that you want to have to come through, use this slider. It's also pretty handy. So there's also another mode here of maximizing, ERC2, but it's also pretty heavy on the CPU. So I'm using also every time just ERC1. And but you can try it out if it makes some difference for you. So the imager is also great when you want to have more stereo field, more stereo wideness, and an equalizer you can use for different stuff if you want, but I don't need it. I just turn all these two modules off and I just use the maximizer with the learn threshold method. So pretty great plugin. Also, it's free, so it can replace your peak limiter of Bitwig, which is pretty basic peak limiter, and use this instead. It's pretty handy, it's pretty nice, it's cheap, and it's available now. So I put all the links in the description so you can download this and also the project. And thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.